All right, cool. So, oh wow, we are playing bass only.
Oh, this is gonna be funky. All right.
I did not realize what commentating elite match means. Okay, so right off the start, opening village. So that's really bad for two reasons. The first is that you didn't open chapel, and the second is that the village does absolutely nothing for you in your first draw through. The village is just acting as a cantrip, meaning it just gives you a card and an action. So it's just like you didn't have a village in your deck. Actually, if you buy it with Smithy, which is what happened, it's worse than not having a card in your deck because it's a card that you can draw dead rather than like drawing a copper.
Yep. And I love Prolog opens Chapel Silver. So getting that trashing in.
Chapel Silver sounds good to me.
Yep, trashing, so immediately getting thin.
Right, so here's the thing I was just talking about, where opening a village made it so your smithy actually drew a card dead that could have potentially been something else.
Yeah, so I'm just going to do village draw.
I mean,
kind of.
Village Smithy looks like the thing to start off with until you can get labs and witches and artisans. I mean, I definitely want a village. I would open Chapel Silver, and then from there, I'm not sure, like, what I would add to my deck depends a lot on what price points I hit, which is going to depend a lot on how that chapel comes up in my shuffle.
Yeah, and you can do gain and play things with artisan.
Yeah. I definitely want an artisan as soon as possible. If I spike six for some weird reason, I would buy artisan before I bought witch since there's chapel on the board.
Yeah, and also just some merchants. Like,
merchants are okay. They seem like, I mean, if I hit three or four here and I don't have like terminals in my deck, then I would get them, but they usually seem worse than village to me.
Like, yeah. Unless you already have, like, extra actions and you don't need the others.
Okay, so, if you have plenty of villages, sure, but there's one village off the board right now, so I think they could both use a lot more villages. So, I love Prolog goes for Witch first. I would have liked to see Artisan instead of Witch as the first. To be fair, he doesn't have a village to support the artisan, but he also doesn't have a village to support the witch, so.
Yep, and now MaPoNoodles mirrors the witch.
So here he can trash down to just a silver and buy a village, or he could trash just an estate and buy a five. I think he really needs a village in his deck because he just added in,
multiple terminals.
Yeah, so I would definitely go for the line that just grabs a village. Okay, he buys another merchant.
Yeah, village is better. You can actually play your terminals.
Yeah.
Like, for economy, you have already.
Yeah, so when did MaPoNoodles buy a chapel?
MaPoNoodles got the chapel turn six.
Yeah, so you almost always want to open chapel. Trashing does more for you at the start of a game than it does later on in the game. And say, like, here, if you had a village, you'd be able to play this merchant, the chapel. What does he pick up for five? He buys a merchant for five. That I just don't like all these merchants.
Yeah, merchant spam.
I want to see some villages. I want to see an artisan so we can gain some labs.
Like, MaPoNoodles gets a lab right here.
Yeah. And here he's just drawing stuff dead. You know, like, you need a village to support these terminals. And I feel like they are making sort of one of the classic newer player mistakes of just buying whatever price point they hit. With the exception of the fact they haven't touched artisan. So there's still only one village off the board on a board where you clearly need villages.
Yeah.
Like, you want villages to support that witch, to support that artisan.
And you definitely want Artisan because it's extra gains. And
It's the only extra gains on the board. So if
yes.
we play mirrored decks and I have an artisan and you don't, I'm gonna be able to use that artisan to grab duchies and win in the end game.
It's like I'd get artisan here.
Yeah, that feels like a good idea. You can do things like artisan, gain a lab, top deck, and buy a village.
Oh no.
Another merchant. Okay, I do not understand this fascination with merchants. It doesn't need more economy right now. It's just more stuff to draw dead with which.
Yeah, and once you're hitting 8, you can buy any card that you want because there's no plus buy. You just consistently hit 8 and buy whatever you need.
Okay, not sure why he doesn't trash the estate. Seems like he thinks that the one, or I should say they, seems like they think the one victory point keeping the estate is going to matter here, but I see this game is going to be decided by a lot more than that. So here, because he doesn't have a village, because they don't have a village, for the second time now, they've had to play their chapel instead of playing their witch, so they're losing out on cursing their opponent. And since they are much thinner than their
All
opponent, they definitely want to be.
right.
All right,
Doesn't
please.
trash the second copper. Which
Yeah.
I'd trash the copper since you're already hitting 6. And
Yeah, there's no reason.
finally buying a
Finally gets a
village.
village. Finally gets a village. And this is what happens when you don't trash and you don't have villages to support your terminals. You draw sad hands like this.
Yeah, like MaPoNoodles got chapel late, so now they've got 2 estates and 2 curses.
I think they actually might have. How many estates are in their
Three
trash? Yeah, so they have 3 estates
and two
still,
curses
and 2 curses.
and
Now 3 curses.
coppers.
Yeah.
So they really need to
Okay,
thin
please
down.
buy an artisan. Such a good card.
More gains? Like, you really want more gains.
I mean, it's a single buy board. So, okay, laboratory. The thing about buying laboratory is that artisan could be getting you a laboratory that you can then top deck for your next turn.
Yep, or you can top deck something else and then draw that back and another card if you want.
Yep, if you have a village in play, you can do gain and play stuff where artisan gains you a lab and then you can play the lab.
Alright, so here MaPoNoodles doesn't draw into a village and has to skip playing witch.
And again, does not trash an estate with chapel. I don't know if they think that that one victory point or the victory points from estate are going to somehow save them, but they are not. Those are junk cards in your deck, and you are way behind on trashing. You need to be killing all your coppers and estates and curses. Looks like
Good
just
undo.
small bell misplay. Yep, played village before witch. No biggie. And this is where having an artisan would be great, right? Because you could actually be doing something more than just,
Yeah, gain and play.
yeah, right now you're just kind of spinning.
So artisan here is probably the best buy that you can do.
Like, I would have wanted to see an artisan a while ago, but it's never too late. I mean, it is at some point, like when the game's almost over. There we go. Buys an
There,
artisan.
hey,
Hey!
it's pretty good.
Okay, Smithy drawing stuff dead. I mean, this is very over. I mean,
Yeah,
this is resignable, honestly.
as far as like trashing goes, I found at lower levels, players are pretty reluctant to trash cards that they think are good. Like sometimes they won't trash like actions or even like golds when trashing that is a good play with like whatever card they have.
Yeah, I mean, those are more advanced things. I think for this game, at least, like, there's some very simple trashing that's not happening, which is coppers and estates.
Yeah.
You don't want to hold on to those estates. They're not going to win you the game. They're going to lose you the game.
Because they don't do much, and if you have them, they just clog up your deck.
So here, I'd want to see another gold. Or, okay, he goes for merchant. I don't think...
Merchants
need...
and silver, it's an okay economy.
It's a peddler. It's a peddler, for sure. But you only have, like, one stop card in your deck right now. I think adding a gold is totally fine. Because at some point in the end game, you might get into situations where you don't draw your silver.
Yeah. Well, now, like, I love
okay,
prologue.
So please, no! You don't just trash two estates. Trash two estates and... I mean, don't just trash two curses. You gotta trash those estates.
Oh.
Okay, request an undo. Are they listening?
Nah. A copper. Okay. A copper. Alright. I mean, that's better. It's better
than nothing, but there you clearly want to trash two estates and two curses. Those are the stop cards in your deck. When by stop cards, we mean... No, copper's also a stop card, but it's at least slightly better than an estate or a curse because it gives you a money.
Yeah, no, I love Prolog is drawing their deck.
Yeah.
And
because
no.
They've gotten thin. So here I want to see artisaning actually for a village because I want the option to be able to add a little bit more stuff to my deck in terms of gain and play. But it looks like they're going to do the artisan lab thing again, which is fine. Draw is draw. They're in a very one position. I think just not blowing this lead and sort of playing conservatively, which apparently means gaining another merge. So they want to have pure merchant silver economy, which, like I said, is fine while you still have such strong deck control, but at some point it can collapse in the end game.
Yeah, and also, like, a second village would be good, so that you're sure to have it when you need it.
Yeah, exactly. I would have liked to have seen a gold instead of another merchant at some point, and using artisan to gain a village. So here, again, they do not kill their estate with chapel, and they have two chapels, which I get why you would pick up a second chapel, because you're like, wow, I'm really behind in trashing, I guess I should have a chapel. But
really you're just not trashing as much as you can with the one chapel.
And adding that second chapel isn't going to get you trashed any faster because, like, you want one chapel and you want to see it as often as possible. Adding a second chapel, because you can't play two chapels a turn. I mean, even if...
Yeah. Network stuff. All right.
Yeah. But this is the kind of I can see building this deck at this level, right? Like it seems like a strong deck, doesn't have many stop cards. It's gaining a laboratory every turn. I get this deck, right? It doesn't seem unreasonable.
Yeah, and
from I Love Prologue, whereas MaPoNoodles is just floundering.
Now they're ahead, and you can actually just pile Curse Lab Merchant in two turns.
You can, but I really doubt they're going to do that. But yes, you could just pile...
And you could even, like, artisan for lab, buy victory cards, like, buy a province.
Yeah.
And then...
And once labs are out, artisan for merchant, buy merchant to finish. Yeah, so MaPoNoodles buys a duchy, which doesn't feel unreasonable there, because you can't really take another lab because piles are so low.
Yeah, and...
But everything you do is losing at this point. It's just up to I Love Prologue to not throw this game somehow.
Yeah, MaPoNoodles has
hard to do.
Four green cards now, plus all the curses.
Yeah, MaPoNoodles, and still just a single village for all their terminals. for two smithies and a wedge.
I guess so. Now three more games and the game's over.
Yep. So we'll probably see I Love Prolog do the same sort of golden deck they've been doing, where they're going to take a lab, top deck it by a province, and then let's see if they see piling out merchants on their last turn.
Yeah, that'll be the thing. Do they keep going for green, or will they see the win? Yeah, like, they're still drawing deck.
Yep. So you're thinking even chapel away a curse and then artisan for something. Presumably artisan lab again.
You can just see that the artisan has made I Love Prolog have a lot more cards, and the early chapel has let them trash down really quickly.
Yep. Even though I don't like using a merchant stack as your main form of economy, because there's just really good draw on this board in the form of village, smithy, witch, lab, artisan, like those all say that I can draw my deck with. So it's okay to add some stop cards in the form of, like, treasure.
Oh, J-Nails is here. Hi.
Hey, J-Nails.
So, now I Love Prolog can win next turn.
Let's see if they spot the win. So it seems like MaPoNoodles has just resigned themselves to just buying whatever the green card that they can afford is.
Yeah,
the slowest of resigns. Buys a silver. Alright. Not sure why you do that over Duchy at this point. But, okay. Sure.
Yep, now Prolog is gonna... Yep. Here's the win.
Let's see if Prolog sees it.
Come on.
Hey! Artisan's for a merchant. Top deck's a merchant. Now all you gotta do is play that silver and buy a merchant.
Oh!
No! So close! So close!
J-Nails,
so close.
Finish him. Oh!
Finish him. Finish him.
Oh.
It's okay. He's gonna gain a they're gonna gain a merchant on this turn.
That's a great hand right there. Alright, end actions, win the game. Yay!
Yay.
Alright. It's 1-0.
Alright, so well played from I Love Prolog, like we were saying. There were some small mistakes. I don't love the merchant stack as economy. I think you could have built with treasure and using some more of the draw that was on the board. I would have liked to see a village earlier so that you could have started, playing your terminals a little more, building a little more, getting that artisan gain and play going a little faster, potentially support like two artisans. But overall, like, very well played. You got deck control. You added payload. You cursed the hell out of your opponent. And you won the game. So, good job.
All right, here we go, game two.
Bureaucrat Gardens! Bureaucrat Gardens! Normally, I need to laugh. J-Nails is such a funny guy.
All right.
All right,
there's no villages.
Poacher. There's no villages. Opening poacher seems reasonable to me. I think poacher silver is probably the open here.
Yeah, unless you like get 5-2, then
yeah.
I might get sentry.
Yep, I would absolutely get sentry if I had the 5-2. Sentry is one of the best cards in the game. It's also like maybe the best card in the game to open. it is a ridiculously high tempo trasher, and if you get it really early, it can just get your deck under control extremely fast. So here, this first five should absolutely be sentry. Buy a sentry. And they buy a mine. So mine is a terrible card.
It's slow and...
Do you want to talk about why mine sucks?
Yeah, it's like slow and it doesn't really do much. You get one more coin and you keep it, but it's just slow and there's not even a village, so you're using up your one non-terminal to...
Yeah. Jay Nels likes Poacher Vassal. That also seems reasonable. Poacher Vassal, Poacher Silver.
Yeah, because...
Both seem good. Vassal is the upside that it can flip a dead card. So, you know, you can get an estate or a copper out of the way.
Plus, if you draw them together, you can play both. Or you can even play Vassal and it can flip Poacher for you. And
yep.
That'll get you even maybe six.
So iloveprolog very smartly buys a sentry, and it looks like there are two sentries gone. iloveprolog bought two sentries, so iloveprolog is already making just great decisions. Sentry is such a good card. Why stop at one? Buy two. Get your deck under control.
Yeah.
So here, this mine is effectively a copper, right? Because all it did was add one more money. And something's telling me they're going to buy a profit.
Oh.
Yeah.
There you go. Yeah, so...
So, please, you go.
I'm guessing, like, a good strat here, get some sentries and labs. Like, after you're thin with, like, the sentry, yeah, get labs, draw deck, buy all the things. And, like, the terminal card here, like, council room, because plus buy more cards.
Is now a dead card in your deck. So you just made your deck worse. You did gain a temporary VP lead, but now for the rest of the game, you're carrying around that province with you. That dead card. So you made your deck worse when you hit a nice high roll, rather than making it better by adding, like, a sentry or a laboratory. Province does slightly less for your deck than Miser. PQR, it appears... Is this League J? So, yes, it appears they don't have subs. Believe we are playing base only. Which I did not know before signing up to commentate. I am slightly... So if you look at, like, iloveprolog's deck, they've got deck control. They're drawing their whole deck. So I would say don't green here. Resist the temptation. Add a little more payload first. Maybe a gold, maybe another lab. And then you can start greening.
Yeah, maybe one council room for the buy.
Yeah. MaPoNoodles is player one again. Were they player one in the last game? I don't know off the top of my head. Also, they're playing rated.
Yes.
This is hardcore. I do not play my league matches rated.
Dombot confirms that MaPoNoodles did start the first game.
So here I'd like to see a gold buy for a little more economy before we start greening. I don't think you want a green with just 8 money in your deck.
Yeah, you want a bit more, just in case you don't get all of it.
Yeah, another lab is fine as well. Like, this game isn't going particularly quickly. MaPoNoodles doesn't have the kind of deck where they can all of a sudden buy 5 provinces or anything like that. So, they also would no longer have 8 money if they trashed any copper. Yes, that's true. You definitely want to be trashing copper when sentry lines up with it.
Yeah, I agree with J-Nails too. One council room for the plus buy would be a great addition. Especially if you have extra, so then you can get, like, province and something else.
Yeah, I mean, if you can add something like province and a lab or province and a sentry to your deck every turn, you don't have to be doubling. Like, a very common mistake, I guess, I see at lower levels is, like, oh, I can build to, like, you know, 16 money and 2 buys, like, I gotta do that. But, Okay, I think it's probably a little early for council room, since you're a little short on money, but that's fine.
Yeah, also, you. I mean, you can, like, lower a pile or even empty it, since if you're overdrawing, you
Yeah.
can just draw back anything that you discard to poacher. Council room ruined market, an opponent half invested.
Yeah.
It also draws cards.
Yes, but you don't want to be drawing cards most of the time with Council Room. You want Council Room just as your plus buy. So here you clearly play
I mean, like,
stuff.
if a pile's empty, you discard some treasures with Poacher, and then at the very end, draw them back with Council
Yep,
Room.
for sure. That could come up if lab's empty, which seems like a reasonable thing.
Or if
Especially
Poacher's
now they're
empty. Because
yes.
they're also low, and MaPoNoodles might go for those instead.
Yep. It also sets up for sentry trashes. This is very true. You can discard with Poacher and then know that those cards are in the discard and use your sentry to finally kill off those last couple annoying coppers. So I'm
Indeed.
guessing we're gonna see another poacher, yep.
Base set strats.
Base set strats. I do not play base. I haven't played a game of base in like a year and a half. I will admit I'm definitely rusty on base. On some of the base set strats.
Council room
Especially
money.
the second edition base set strats, because I used to play with first edition base when I actually played with it on paper.
PQR says council room money.
Council Room money is especially in first edition base, Council Room money is dominant.
But here you've got like labs, you've got poacher. Those are pretty good to have in your deck.
I don't think I would play Council Room money, but I could certainly see it winning. The other thing is it's simpler to play. I take one sentry of the money in Council Rooms. Yeah, that's how I would play it. So that's certainly a strategy, and it's a lot lower execution than some of these other strategies because you're not making many decisions. You're basically just buying money and council rooms. And so if you're good at judging how much money you have in your deck and where the council rooms are and when it's time to add a second council room, you can play money very effectively. Please trash this estate. No, discards the estate. Yeah, you really gotta buy some estates. I mean, wow.
So you're ahead, like, in the short term, but then in the long term, it ends up that your deck is bad and you can't really do anything anymore.
Is very strong.
All right.
Not sure what they're thinking over so carefully. You pretty clearly want to play.
Buys another province.
Yeah, I think they're scared because their opponent has a big VP lead.
But you should know that, like, your opponent
Has no deck.
can't consistently keep scoring, so
Yeah.
you
So it's
can
time to
buy
add
like
an.
another
You can
gold
buy some.
instead.
Yeah, exactly. You can add more treasure and realize that your opponent's not going to be able to take three provinces before you take a bunch of duchies. So if you're building more, it's worth it.
Yeah, and if you build
You're
to
going to
like
be able to outscore them.
even province duchy, that'll work.
So here, you know, I love Prologue could be in trouble if
Yes.
Mappo hits, which it looks like they're going to. They do. Probably went a little too happy for labs and never added payload. I agree.
Yes, and I mean, Province Duchy wins here by a point.
But they don't have enough payload for it.
So now we just have to hope that Mapo duds this
Which is
turn.
very likely. So yeah, buy a duchy. Yep. I agree, PQR. That was most of Mappo's money. That was a big high roll.
Oh, playing the council
Playing the
room.
council room. That
That's
really helped.
an extra card from Mappo.
Yeah.
You
And it's not like you.
could have gotten the duchy anyways, right?
And yeah, it on the top decks the lab you just top decked. It gets you a harbinger, which does almost nothing.
Oof. See, 2, 4, 7. It's very close. Not quite. Yeah, and that harbinger is weird because wouldn't you
Yep.
rather buy a silver or a vassal so you can actually have money?
Yeah, Harbinger does absolutely nothing for your deck.
It's one of the worst cards that you can have.
And unfortunately, Isle of Prologue is a little bit behind in VP, and so it's gonna have to take another duchy here. Garden's potentially giving up the draw. Yeah, gardens over duchy seems sketchy. I don't think MaPoNoodles has enough time to make gardens pay off.
And especially with like it being a single buy board. Except for Council Room, which Mappo doesn't have.
It's gonna be very hard to get those gardens up. To be fair, they haven't been trashing for most of the game, so the gardens are worth 2 VP right now, at least. But they aren't great. I think a duchy there would have been a lot better.
Right, yep, so now I just have to.
Ooh, Isle of Prolog just drew all their green.
Ow. I have to hope that Mappo gets unlucky, which now they can put lab on top and nope, another 7.
Yep, lucky number 7. I mean, imagine if this mine was a lab. Okay, they buy gardens again, so Mappo, so they give up, they offer a tie.
Yeah, if Isle of Prolog takes the province, then that'll be even. Daniel's
Should have
saying,
trashed mine. Yeah, could have kept that on.
yeah, and if you trash mine, you might have drawn into like another silver or gold. And does Iloveprolog Prolog have 10? They don't. A harbinger over silver was probably a pretty big mistake.
Yep. Yeah, take the tie here for sure.
Yeah, gardens is worth 1 or 2.
There were two right now. Oh, for iloveprolog?
Yeah.
Let's see, they have three. Okay, Thighs. Doesn't take the tie.
Duchy silver. Well, yeah, Mappo can only get
gardens.
And now iloveprolog also has a bit more economy from the one silver. Yeah.
So they should be able to win here on their turn. Don't play labs before sentries. No, you're drawing cards dead. You want to always play your sentries first till you know that the two cards lab are drawing aren't dead cards.
Alright, so yeah.
Stop cards, sorry. Province. I'm saying dead cards. I mean stop cards.
Province wins here.
Yep, province just wins.
That's game. Even without playing all these extra cards, you can just end actions and
win.
But
you want to... I would have played the council room and then bought an estate for swag. Okay, good stuff, iloveprolog. They got, you know, they maybe rushed into greening a little too early because their opponent was greening aggressively, but they still managed to hold on and win the game.
Yes, truffles. Base match.
I think a big mistake from MaPoNoodles, besides mint instead of sentry, and just generally greening way too early, was in the end game they were buying gardens and they're only worth two. If they were buying duchies, it would have been much harder for iloveprolog to catch up. Okay.
Right,
okay, they did switch the play order. They actually did switch it this time.
Yeah, Mappo had accidentally gone twice first. And no first player advantage.
Yeah. These games haven't been too much about FBA. I mean, that second one definitely came down to who was player one mattered a little bit. Oh my god, dude.
Franklin W's back.
It's the guy who thinks Miser's really good.
Yes. The best card in the game, according to the Werewolf chat.
When even Donald is like, it's a pretty weak card, like, you gotta...
Alright, Mapple has learned, and they've gotten a chapel.
Nice.
Will they
Let
use
us
it
see
right?
What they use it, yes. So we're seeing a lot of, I think I like Chapel Poachers in open. Chapel Silver also fine. Buy a sentry. It's a really good 5-cost card.
It's probably the best one here right now.
Oh, it's definitely the best one
the best one here at all, because, like, you don't even really want library in the late game either. So you just draw with, like, Smithy. Oh.
No, not time for Smithy. You want that sentry because it lets you trash your chapel, lets you trash your coppers, and then later in the game, it's going to let you discard your provinces and stuff and make your draws better.
You don't even have terminal space for the smithy. No villages. You've got workshop for some extra cheap gains. Like if you want a ton of villages or poachers or whatever.
Okay, trash your whole hand here. Just trash it. No, you don't want to keep one copper.
One copper that you can't even do anything with. Right, end turn. It's two, you can't do anything with two.
No. Gotta keep that copper. And why did we just buy a mine? You don't even have treasures. Oh my god, this Gabe is gonna kill me. Oh.
Welcome to Chile.
You don't even have... you don't have treasures that you want to use mine on.
Right,
but
Sentry.
Mine is also just a bad card.
Sentry.
Village. Okay, village just seems a little worse than workshop, because workshop will gain you more villages. But you do have a terminal problem right now with the smithy in your deck, so I get why you'd buy the village.
Alright, Mapo buys a sentry. Which is pretty good.
That's a good card. Good card.
But are you going to trash your coppers and estates with it?
Okay, so here I want to see this chapel trashing a bunch, and then I want to see a workshop.
Yeah, trash everything, all the coppers, workshop is good, then... You can workshop.
From there, you can just workshop smithies and silvers. Get yourself a remodel at some point for some late game control. Smithies, silvers, villages. No, I don't like this line.
Unless you buy a sentry. Ugh.
No, you don't need another smithy. You already are drawing your whole deck and you don't have more than one village.
Yeah, no. The only reason to keep five is if you really want a sentry. But.
Which you don't need at this point. Trashing to five, then buying a four cost doesn't really follow. Yeah, it doesn't make a ton of sense. So MaPoNoodles is very clean. They buy a poacher for seven. I don't like that. They're trashing a three for a workshop or six for a gold. Yeah, sure. Right, and so they just drew a whole bunch of stuff dead.
You need workshops here. Because no other extra games.
Yep, I mean, there's no plus buy. That's why I don't like base, because the games are just so like, well, there's no plus buy. You're like, oh, the only games are workshop. Like, guess we're both just like playing an identical strategy. It's like very boring.
Yeah, you don't have engineer or inventor, like
you don't have any of the cool cards. Basically, there are some great cards in base that make base more fun to play, that work really well with all the expansions. Probably wouldn't grab another gold there before I started greening as Mapo. Also, since you're essentially just playing money, I probably want a smithy. But you've been buying poachers, so that doesn't really work with the smithy, and neither does the mine. But if you wanted to just play this like very simple money deck, trash down with chapel, get a smithy, add some money, and then play smithy money.
Yeah, it feels like just Maple's just going for the most expensive buy. Alright, so Prologue.
Again, I love Prologue still hasn't killed off these last two coppers. At least the Vassal adds some payload, I guess. But it really, like, you need a workshop. You just have too many terminals.
Extra gains, man.
You need gains?
Gain villages, gain poachers.
Gaining villages is going to be huge because you have all these terminals. And then once you have gained some villages, you can add in more smithies. Prove your reliability.
Yeah, and you can just add poachers if you want. Whatever.
Yeah, poacher, vassal, if you need more payload, or silver. Silver's not a bad card on this board by any means. Like, what is that smith you bought doing? You're already overdrawing.
Alright, so now you want to trash your coppers. Come on.
At least trash one copper if you're gonna buy gold. Okay,
hey,
there we go.
There we go.
Bio workshop. Workshop. I know it costs three and you have five, but you need the game. Vassal, no. You can gain it with workshop and you still don't have the terminal space for it. Yeah, Noodles just needs to add a smithy and can start clicking green, but they like clicking poacher instead. Don't like that.
Alright, workshop. Come on.
I mean, at this point,
gains?
It might just be gold.
Actually, yeah, just village smithy.
You have
single province.
Villages.
Just make a single province deck.
Well, I mean, it was almost. Yeah, I mean, I don't know. I still want to build. I want to remodel. I want to workshop. But I wanted them a lot of turns earlier. Poacher, what is it with their love for peddlers? It's okay to buy gold, guys.
It replaces itself in your hand and it gives you money. Oh my god, it's amazing.
Except when you have all this terminal draw. Yellow equals purple. It's okay to add some gold into your deck.
Payload. If you have like a couple or like one or two workshops, you can buy province and then you can add a village or a smithy and keep your deck running smoothly.
Yep. The idea of greening while still adding in reinforcement, like, you know, still building and still making your deck more resilient to duds, something that we saw I Love Prolog did really well in game one, where they were constantly, you know, buying province, but also top decking a lab with artisan.
Yeah, and then you can keep going, keep buying green.
And you're not just buying green, you're making your deck more resistant to duds. So you did add a stop card, but you also top deck a lab. So they kind of balance themselves out. Whereas here, it seems like the strategy is just going to be to click on green cards. These decks are going to choke under green. But honestly, this is looking pretty good for Mappo right now.
Yeah.
Okay.
Province.
You can trash
lead.
The chapel, toss the province.
And now you can get another province, and that's a 2-province lead.
Yeah, with no extra gains on the board, that should be.
Yeah, it's probably game since drew both golds together. Really, now if Mappo just sentry. Try to get any like poacher and buy one province, then that's game over. Yeah, like, and if Prolog buys the penultimate province, which they do, now Mappo basically has a guaranteed win. Here's a gold and a poacher, that's already plenty. Doesn't even matter what order they put
the order
them back.
Yeah, doesn't matter, just don't trash them. Yep, and that's a win. Great, so Mappo gets on the board.
2-1 for Prolog.
So again, I really don't like mine. I think if your intention is just to play a money deck, Smithy money is a lot better than mine money.
Yeah,
I would have liked to see it.
Way
mine
too
is
slow.
It's slow, it's bad, it's not good. I would have liked to see workshop from both players. As a way to both build the engine, I mean, it's not really an engine, but it's a way to add cards to your deck. You know, there's a bunch of good 3 and 4 cost cards like Village, Smithy, Poacher. So being able to add those to your deck makes your deck sort of spiral up in power.
Yeah. All right.
And there's even opportunities if you're able to do stuff like adding remodel to get some late game potential with remodeling silvers to duchies, remodeling golds to provinces, remodeling provinces to provinces to end the game.
Alright, what do we have here? We have festival and market. Finally we've got buy.
We have chapel again. So
chapel,
with
sentry, and moneylender.
I think, yeah, the 3 cards that trash and base are all here. And witch is here too. And so, well, I guess bandit trashes. We forget about that, but
it's just spam the 5 costs.
So I think I would open. Oh, they both. You got to open chapel. Okay, good. So I think with chapel, I'm opening. Either Vassal Chapel or Silver Chapel. I don't want to open Moneylender because I don't want to have many coppers. Oh, and for the record, there actually is an autoplay, and he goes for bandas the first five.
It gains gold. Isn't that so great?
No, because those golds are stop cards in my deck. Alright, don't be too mean. Chapel silver for me. Yeah, I think for me too, PQR.
Unless you get like 2/5, then you're really good. Like,
then you're just really happy.
Chapel and any top row 5.
But yeah, you want sentry before you want bandit. You want bandit once you have some deck control to add payload to your deck, because adding a gold to your deck is great to do once you have some semblance of deck control.
You can just spam the 5s in the top row, because they're all pretty good cards.
Chapel Sentry is a great open. Yeah, that's one way to put it. Chapel Sentry might be like the best open possible in base.
I mean, also, like, if you want, like, open like Chapel Witch and hope they don't collide.
Yeah, but even in the collision cases, it's not that bad. Either Witch shuffles you back around and you have a short shuffle, or Chapel, like, where you don't play the Witch and you just Chapel 3 cards and see your Witch more often.
Yeah, and then, like, or if you, like, play the Witch and then you can buy, like, Festival, so then no more terminal problems.
Yeah, I mean, it's all winning from there. Anyway, Witch's first 5, not crazy, but also not Sentry.
Yeah, and they're getting labs, and Sentry's the only untouched 5 now.
Yeah, Sentry is my first 5 on any base board, and on a lot of non-base boards. Sentry's just that good.
It's good. You can trash your cards early, you can discard green later, you can deal with curses from Witch, like, as they're coming in.
Yeah. So you don't want a big pool of curses you can't deal with.
You can get rid of your chapel after you're done quickly trashing down.
Yep.
Yeah, MaPoNoodles does not have neither chapel nor sentry, so all those curses are going to build up.
I want a festival as prologue, and then probably I want a bandit. Okay. Finally buys a sentry. Sentry's good. So here, play festival, kill an estate, and I could see bandit, I could see market, I could see lab. They're all decent.
Yeah.
You have enough deck control now, I think adding bandit's not bad, plus you have a risk of some of your crucial treasures getting trashed since you don't have much deck left. So I think it makes sense to add in a bandit.
Yeah, and like having just festivals, markets, labs, play cards, draw cards, get money.
Yeah, like you're drawing deck right now, which means time to add in bandit. Right, then you're adding in a gold every turn, you can keep adding in more draw. No, not festival, man. Festival doesn't even draw cards.
Yeah, and festival not drawing cards, like, you need labs, but bandit's good. You can bother your opponent either discarding actions or trashing silver and gold.
Yep. You get the attack is pretty mild, but it's still an attack. And the main part of it is that you're able to, if you have deck control ready when you add in bandit, yes, every time you play bandit, you add a stop card in the form of gold. But Festival is also essentially a stop card.
Also, you can, like, if you're drawing deck, you can gain and then immediately draw the gold right away.
And the thing is, if what you're doing with your buys isn't buying more money, it's buying more draw. And that synergizes really well with the bandit, because the bandit's naturally adding more payloads so that you can buy more.
Don't buy gold. Bandit gains gold.
You don't have to buy gold on a bandit board. Oh, and it does hit a silver, so that cost him some economy.
Yeah, and
Yeah,
Province,
they're.
an early Province for MaPoNoodles again.
Yeah, this is a board where you can definitely build big.
You can build double, like with all the golds you're getting.
You can build double easily. But it
Prolog
looks.
copies the province. Mean, I just build to double, like right away.
I'd build to double, try to, win the lab split. Those are what feel important to me. Get thin, win the lab split, build to double, win the game.
Yeah,
Possibly even,
if you build
double
to
plus.
double and your opponent builds to just single, then
You win every time.
yeah, they can't do anything.
Okay, so are they thinking about building bigger or are they just gonna green again? I mean, hopefully they realize their opponent's deck is garbage, right? Like, it's just full of bad stuff. So
Yeah.
they do have the opportunity to build. Like, they're not under threat of getting raced out on provinces. Okay, so we see a festival, which again is a stop card and is effectively just acting as a virtual silver here for five. And Harbinger does nothing for your deck. I really want to see a bandit. If you're gonna buy a Harbinger, you should at least buy a vassal or something, something that adds payload. Okay, these festivals are just stop cards. They need more draw at this point. Yeah, for sure. Like laboratories and bandit. Like one
Like,
bandit and then some labs.
you think here in this game, not getting bandit for I Love Prolog is probably the main, like, misplay since bandit.
Yeah, well, there's been a bunch of festival buys. Okay, buys silver over Harbinger there, so realizes Harbinger is a bad card and doesn't do anything. That's good.
Yeah, but like, bandit, it adds payload. If you're drawing deck, then you can play bandit, draw the gold immediately, and then use that gold the same turn that you gain it.
Yeah. There's no reason not to build here. And one of the best ways, because there's no real payload, I mean, festival and market are payload, but they cost $5 for a dollar or a peddler. Instead, you can be adding payload using bandit, which is also going to be attacking your opponent's payload at the same time.
Yes, Province Bandit. I mean, now I Love Prolog can double. But yeah, so just province lab, or double one turn and then keep doing that. Alright, and that's game.
Wish that dropped for a little bit, but the iloveprolog closed that out.
Yeah. And you can see, like, MaPoNoodles, all the curses.
Seven curses, three estates. Still had a copper.
Yeah, MaPoNoodles has started first three times because double firsting, so I'll actually just at them in chat real quick to make sure that first players are even. Even though, like, in base matters less than otherwise, but still important.
Any building to single, you're gonna win.
Alright, so it's 3-1 for iloveprolog. And second player has won every game.
The second player advantage kind of thing. Maybe these base players just know something that we don't.
Yeah, so just quick check for even first starts. Gotta make sure that there's a balance since Mappo had gone first twice.
Yeah, hopefully they see your message and they figure that out.
Prolog has seen it, then suppose they'll at least tell Mappo. I see that the two of them are actually in a separate game chat together, which is neat. Still resolving so, starts.
Looks like they saw the message and everything, so we should get correct starts from everyone. Well, at least balance starts, so, you know, everyone has the same number of firsts as they do seconds.
Yeah. No. Just doubling up, switching, then.
As long as it evens out in the end, it's all good.
Yeah. Like, you can save effort and switch halfway through. MaPoNoodles has left the table. So apparently, I have become the host, but MaPoNoodles is not here. Both players have left.
Yes, I was saying, did they make a new table?
Yes, they have.
They're in a game chat together right now. That's probably how they're talking. Huh, interesting.
Alright, so now iloveprolog gets to start these two games.
Alright, have you found their new table?
Yes.
Cool, I can just leech off of you and not have to actually add anyone to my friends list.
Truffles is performing some espionage in game chat too.
Yeah, I saw. Make sure they're not colluding.
Got a mod, you know.
mod's gonna mod. So here, I think you gotta open militia.
Nice. There it is.
I think that you have the potential to build quite big on this board. You got throne room, village, council room, artisan.
You've got villages, gains, draw all the things, buys.
Yeah.
You've bandit for some payload. If you want to gain golds.
So, we saw a moat open from MaPoNoodles. Raven, do you want to explain why you don't want to open moat?
Raven?
Monster.
Raven's not here.
Don't judge me. I forget who I'm talking to sometimes. Anyway.
Moat's just not a good card to open with. Like, yes, you can block attacks, but it's much better to open with a card which actively benefits your deck. I Love Prologue also buys a moat.
So yeah, the problem with moat is in order for moat to block the attack, it has to be in your hand. And then you have a moat in your hand.
And
so you might not have had to discard two cards, but you have at least one card that you wish was something else in your hand.
Yeah, and you can draw two cards, but if they're actions, they're just going to be dead.
Yeah.
And now, early on, you can just discard two estates, or an estate and a copper.
It's okay to buy moat on a two here, for sure. But I wouldn't open it.
Alright, Prologue has spiked six, so...
I think Artisan. Early Artisan? Interestingly, the first five was Bandit. Not sure I agree with that.
I mean, Mappo got Bandit last game. And
do you think they're just reacting to each other?
Maybe. But yeah, like, get villages, artisans, thrones.
Yep.
All the things.
I want all the
Smithy
cards here.
On six.
Smithy
without
feels
a village.
Worse than council room.
Without a village.
I'm fine adding a big terminal draw card in, but I want it to be council room that I get that plus by. Like, if that Smithy was a council room right here, this could be village throne, village Smithy, you know?
It's like...
throne, again.
But you can't really line throne up well if you don't have deck control.
Yeah, Throne is certainly an amazing card, but it's not time for Throne yet. You need to line Throne up with a target. Make it do stuff.
Yeah, like, I definitely want either Council Room or Artisan because extra gains. Truffles reporting in from the voice cult, too.
I'm glad they're having fun.
It's like playing with paper cards, you know?
Table banter. They're gonna watch this and just be like, oh god, what have we done? Just remember, you requested commentary.
And they requested it very politely.
Very politely. Maybe we should be more polite. We're pretty mean. But hopefully... you take it in stride when you two watch this, because we're not being mean for any reason other than we want you to be better, and we don't like the decisions you made, and we think you could make better decisions, and then hopefully you do, and your
council rooms
get better.
Good. More
council rooms,
buys.
Good.
But I definitely want like villages, because let's see, who has the villages? Mappo has both villages. So, that means
that
Prologue...
So the cool thing about Artisan is it can gain you villages.
And if you have a village, like, if you play a village, and then Artisan, then you can gain a card and play it right away.
Yep.
Which is one of the best things in the base set, in my opinion, is...
Well, in general, gain and play is just very strong, right? Like, you know, you can measure like how strong something is by sort of how long it takes to police by a village. Yay.
A good decision.
For how, like, you can think about, like, one of the problems with potion cards is it takes forever for them to get into your deck and do stuff, right? Like, you first you have to buy the potion, then you have to buy the card, then you have to wait for the card to, like, come around in the shuffle. So, potion cards tend to be, like, really slow. Whereas, like, when you can do gain and play, there's no time between gaining the card and playing it, right? You don't have to, like, put in your discard, shuffle your deck, and then hope to draw it. You're just, like, gaining a card, play a card. It's the best thing you can do in the game, probably. Or, like, not the best thing you can do in the game. That doesn't really make sense. The best thing you can do in the game is win, but it's one of the strongest, like, mechanical elements of the game. Whenever you see gain and play possibilities, you should look at them because they're often very strong. So a bit of a sad hand for I Love Prologue here. I'm not sure what you do. Probably throw in the council room. No, he throws the smithy. The promise doesn't give him buys. Yeah, I get you don't want to give your opponent cards, but, like, you need some buys. You can add some good stuff into your deck. You know, there's not that many villages left.
Yeah, MaPoNoodles is getting a bunch of villages. Yeah, so they're both getting villages. It's good since you want to actually be able to play all your cards.
Yeah, so here you throw in the council room. Okay, I guess playing the moat first is fine.
Oh yeah, that's pretty nice. The thing with throwing council, you draw your opponent cards, but that's almost all their deck. Well, actually, is that all their deck?
No,
before?
Don't start provincing. Okay. So
that seems like
went over this
motif of MaPoNoodles consistently greens early.
As soon as the first time they hit 8. So yeah, you really want to try to work on that. It's lost you some games so far. If you have the opportunity to build, you want to build. On a board like this, you want to build to at least double province.
Yeah, council room, like, bunch of good payload.
There's bandits, add more payload. There's village, there's artisan, there's throne rooms.
Plus, like, late game.
Also, I just realized they don't have a militia.
Yeah.
Council
room militia
crazy.
Is actually a combo.
Yeah.
Your opponent gets cards, they have to discard them all. Unless they have a moat.
I didn't realize that going in. I was like, of course you throw in the council room. But I didn't realize there was no militia down there. So, yeah, council room militia is... Oh, you don't want to throw in a bandit. That's just more stop cards. And you didn't draw anything. I guess you buy the last village. Okay, buy some
militia.
There's a militia. Militias are good. And it's not like losing the village split really hurts here, because you can just start using thrones.
Yep. Another.
But yeah, so council room militia is really strong, because you draw your opponent up to a bunch of cards, and then you make them discard down.
Except moats.
Except for moats.
Which is the importance of moat, because if you're drawing cards from the opponent's council room plays, you have to have your moat in hand, or at the top of your deck. So that makes it that your moat is actually more likely to block the militia than otherwise. All right. Nice top deck for next turn. And all right, 11.
So I think the simple thing here would be like, well, I have enough for village province. Like, that sounds good. But in fact, like, you can build much bigger here.
Yeah, like, village artisan, I think.
Yeah. It Sounds good to me. And you can start artisaning for throne rooms.
Whatever you need at the time.
Oh.
A vassal.
So yeah, if you can build a deck that gets to double, that will almost always beat the deck that settles on single and just starts there. And you might have deck control now, but you're going to lose control of your deck as you add these green cards and more stop cards in, like from Bandit, if you're not also building. Vote before council room is not the right order. Yeah. So you want to try to draw with the card that gives you the most draw first. So you have a better chance of finding another village.
And also another late game strat is artisan for duchies if you're close in points.
Yep.
It's time for pick the terminal or gamble with a vassal.
This is what happens when you don't have enough villages. So you might have considered artisaning for something before you play the smithy.
Yeah, like artisan for the last village. Also, yeah. If you have a council room, like, wouldn't you prefer to council room and draw more cards rather than smithy and
this militia just gets blocked. That is very sad. But yeah, like in general, you want to play the draw cards that give you the most draw first, so you have a better search space. Similar to how you always want to play sentry first so that you can like stop your draw cards from drawing stuff dead or drawing stuff that you want to trash.
Gold.
Don't buy gold when you have Bandit. Bandit, it doesn't, once you've played it once, it's worth more than a gold.
Yep. So MaPoNoodles is doing alright over here.
Yeah, I mean, I think what happens in a bunch of these games is Mapo greens early. And then I Love Prolog is like, well, I need to green because otherwise I'm going to lose. and so then they start in these VP races really early, whereas they could be building significantly more. No, you got to play the throne room on the village there so you have a chance of drawing. So now you hit four. What are you doing with four?
Buying the last village.
Buying the last village instead of gaining it with artisan 30 turns ago.
Well, I mean, I called it.
Congrats.
I mean, it's better than, like, vassal or
yeah,
silver.
I mean, like, it's fine. I don't disagree with it, but I just wish that there were more villages and thrones off the board.
In general, like, greening should be saved for later.
Yeah. You don't want to green the first time you hit 8. You don't want to green before you have deck control, and you want to green in a way that you maintain deck control. So you want to figure out, like, okay, I'm going to add a province into my deck, but I'm also adding a smithy and a village this turn, so that, like, I'm going to be able to still have deck control.
Yeah, and artisan helps with that, since you can, like, gain and additional gains.
Yep.
Additional gains in general help you keep more good cards in your deck as you're putting stop cards, like, that don't do anything in at the same time.
Yeah. Another big thing here is they're not really playing with many throne rooms. Throne room's a great card. Throning a village gives you a ton of actions, and throning something like council room draws big for you.
Yeah, throning artisan, you can gain 2 cards to hand. You can keep going, like, throne artisan, gain a throne and a council room, put 2 cards on top, draw 6 cards and those back. It's just really good. unfortunate hand for our prolog.
For our prolognist. So again, wrong order here. You don't want to play the militia before the count's room, because now you just drew them a card back up.
Yeah, as PQR again said in chat, just if you play the council room, then they're not gonna have more cards in hand because they have to discard down to three anyways.
Yeah, you wanna play council room first and then militia. Estate? You're already winning, Bell. I don't know about estate. Okay, throw in the village here. Don't play the village hoping to find something. Because if you play the village hoping you find an action card, and you don't, then your throne room is just a dead card.
Alright, Prolog gets a duchy. Alright, so two provinces left, and MaPoNoodles is up by 13. So, MaPoNoodles getting one more province is basically game over.
So, yeah, that's fine.
Yeah, my network just cut out for a second, so...
Yeah, you've been cutting out a little bit.
Yeah. I don't have the most consistent connection up here, so...
Okay, well, we're about to run out of duchies, so I think Mapo has half EP.
Yeah, also Mapo is just... Mapo's just won the game because there's no way Prolog can catch up.
Yeah, right, that's player, what I mean. They,
player
they
2.
Another player 2 win. That's what I mean by half EP. They have more than half of the available victory points, so there's no way to catch up and win. If they buy this duchy now, it's just over. Like, there's literally not enough victory points to win. 7 estates in a province doesn't win. You just gotta resign.
Alright, so yeah, so MaPoNoodles probably just wins next turn easily.
I mean, he cannot win too. Like,
nope.
He can take he wins, but he can pass like 30 turns now. Like, there's just not enough VP on the board.
Yeah, so that's 2-3 now. So Prolog starts first again, but if the trends continue, then player
second
2.
Player advantage. We all know about second player advantage.
Yes, but did you know it scales with players? One time, fifth player won the game.
Was that Dan?
Dan Brooks himself.
Yeah, Yeah, Dan won his
Yeah,
fifth player
like
in the
a couple
Quarantine Cup
quarantine
playoff.
cups ago.
Yep, in the Quarantine Cup playoff,
A
yeah.
five-way tie, and so five players, and a crazy game later, fifth player
I
advantage.
didn't watch the game. I just saw Dan had like 43 coppers at the end or something like that.
Oh man, I didn't see it either, but it wasn't
Bureaucrat
recorded.
Garden. Workshop Gardens.
Oh, Workshop Gardens. Can you do a rush?
There's no villager throne, so I wouldn't play Workshop Gardens. And there's no village, but there's still like sentry and lab and market and artisan, so I think the rush loses.
Yeah, like get sentry, trash down, draw with labs, markets, one council room maybe, and
I'm not sure you need the council room.
actually, yeah, that's
You
too
have
much
plus buy,
drawn.
you have draw.
Yeah, buy
I
and
want my
market.
terminal. I want my terminal to be artisan.
It's like sentry, lab, market, then finally an artisan. You really want to get the sentry as quick as you can over
Yeah,
here.
sentry is absolutely my first five. I think I agree with their openings, which I think they both just did moneylender silver. That feels right to me. But this needs to be a sentry. Buy sentry. Buy sentry. Yay!
Yeah, I love Prolog. Is actually pretty good with playing the like engine-y sort of things, like thinning down.
They definitely seem like they have a better grasp over engines and building, whereas Mappo seems to like playing money and a very aggressive greening.
Yeah, the thing with I love Prolog is that the only like mistake is that you don't have to immediately mirror the greening. You can wait a bit, build more, and then green faster later. All right. What's the four? Honestly, like another silver right here on four.
Early and instead own in green first, be like, that's fine. I'm gonna keep building, I'm gonna build to double at least, or I'm gonna build however the board dictates, and then I'm gonna win the game because I built more and I have a better deck.
Yeah. Right, so also Prolog gets an artisan, which is good because now you can gain markets and labs.
Yep, Artisan is a great card. On the other hand, Workshop does not look good on this board,
There's no
because there's no
cheap
good
cards
targets.
that you want. Like none of the fours are good, and all you can get is more workshops and silver.
Yep.
And you don't want silver either, because you're not gonna be drawing anything. It's the stop card again.
So again, I think way too early for Bandit. You don't want these bandits in your deck adding stop cards until you've gotten your labs and your markets and your sentries, gotten your deck under control.
Yes, I mean like
Right?
doing the right things but at the wrong time, kind of.
You want to explain what we mean by deck control?
Like, I mean, I'm kind of
I can.
low level
So.
myself, so.
All right, so by deck control, we mean the general idea that from most starting hands, you're able to draw your deck. So you have your deck under control. And there's generally two ways you can do that, and that's by trashing your deck down and by adding more draw into your deck. And you often want to do both of those things together. But, ooh, nice entry hit. That's juicy. But by doing those things together, or by some boards don't have trashing and draw, you can gain control of your deck. So that outside hand's like a dud, where you just literally draw nothing but stop cards. You should be able to redraw your deck every turn. And that makes, unlike the previous board, for instance, that had Militia, having Militia is so much more valuable when you can play it every turn. But you don't want multiple Militias. You want one Militia that you can play every turn.
And it gets more, like, of an important thing with, like, expansions. Because in base, like, yeah, you can do it, but the expansions just have a lot more things in them. So as Mappo on 6, I think I'd just get Artisan, right? Either that, or if they don't have a Sentry yet, but they do so, yeah.
Yeah, monster, sometimes you go into slow motion. It's actually pretty funny sounding. It's like, what? Like, I remember one point you were like, trashing is good.
Yeah, it kind of, yeah, Discord does that, like, cuts in and out.
So here we have a problem, right, where this is a single terminal board. Right, like there's no villages, so you can only play one terminal per turn. And you have a moneylender and a workshop. I would have liked to have my terminal be Artisan, get good deck control, play my Artisan every turn. Ideally, once the moneylender has done its job, I'm killing it with Sentry.
Yeah, and that's like what's good with Sentry. It's like, if you have an early game Trasher, and then Sentry, you can trash the early Trasher with Sentry, and then keep using the Sentry to filter through, like, green cards later on in the game.
Yep. And yeah, as PQR points out, Prolog hasn't used this workshop once. And why would you, when you have an Artisan and a Moneylender that you already have to choose between? So you play this market for sure.
Yep, then Artisan.
No, it's not that important to kill the copper. I would have liked to see the Artisan get played.
You can kill the copper with Sentry, like, later on, too.
Yeah.
Alright, so yeah, you just want to play labs and markets and sentries, and then finish off with an Artisan.
Yep, top deck a lab. In this case, you could, like, talk to a lab and gain a silver or something.
Yeah, and now just getting more labs. And
there's no reason to buy gold when you have Bandit. I mean, there is, which is that you want to play Artisan instead of Bandit as your terminal.
Yeah, that's the thing. No village. Alright, MaPoNoodles keeps the Moneylender.
Yeah, that's suspicious. That I absolutely would have trashed that if I got it to line up with Sentry.
And here's the early province. Trademark play.
Hit eight by province. So Sentry first, please. Good.
Yeah, this lab split is quite the thing.
Yep. So no, you don't want to play that lab. What you want to do is play the market, then use Artisan to gain a card and top deck that lab.
What would you be gaining with Artisan?
It could just be a silver, honestly.
Yeah.
You have plenty of draw.
Yeah, with all those labs, like, you're not gonna dud that easily, or, like, not be able to go through your deck.
The alternative is something like Artisan for a Market, Top Deck the Lab. I think I like that. You don't get to play the Market this turn, but gives you a little more flexibility to have two Markets.
Yeah, plus, like, just Markets, it's fun to spam.
I guess. They're not a very efficient form of economy, because they cost 5, but if you can gain them rather than buy them... No, it's not time to green yet. You could build for another turn or two. Add some... This could have been, like... I would have liked gold, silver.
Yeah, and like,
I think artisaning for a silver and then buying like market gold or something makes sense. More market seems good. They are overdrawing by a lot.
I guess it's like just to say three things. It's just green later and try not to like underbuild and have deck control, because those are like the things that you do want to be doing.
Okay, play that sentry before. No, play your sentry before these labs and stuff. See, you could have trashed that moneylender if you played sentry in a better position, or a workshop. Those are just dead cards in your deck. Don't play this lab so you can top deck it with artisan.
More markets. Province. Come on, will this be the first player win?
So last turn, Prolog bought a silver and then had it trashed by their opponent's bandit. But this turn, they did correctly do the artisan thing, which is gain a market, top deck a lab, which feels solid. They're overdrawing markets at economy that can't get hit by bandit. So yeah, I think you do buy another silver here. Yeah. Good, sentry before lab. Right, and you could have killed this moneylender earlier. So that could be a better card in your hand.
Yep. Yeah, like, both players are underbuilding in, like, this match. Because sometimes you have boards like, yeah, you only get one province a turn. But other times you can build to, like, province duchy or double.
I mean, just having this artisan means that you're guaranteed to be able to build to province duchy just if you're playing the artisan every turn.
Yeah.
So that alone means that Prolog has a big advantage here heading into the end game. They're probably counting right now to see if they do something like artisaning a silver, if that gets them enough to hit a big price point. It looks like they decide to just grab...
Don't need a duchy yet. I mean,
you probably don't, but I don't hate it.
Yeah, it's alright, like...
You're clearly not building to double. We're getting into the end game. You're gonna buy a province this turn. Take the VP lead.
So now you're in the lead they don't. By 1 point, and... So that ensures that you're basically guaranteed to stay ahead for the rest of the game.
As long as no one duds, yes. If each player just keeps buying... Silver lets you double? I wasn't counting, but... Yeah, I was thinking about artisaning for silver. So yeah. In that case, you definitely want to build to... you definitely want to artisan for silver and then double. I just got lazy and didn't count. It's like the 10th game I've commentated now in a row. Like, I'm getting tired.
Back to back. There's an estate to even it out.
So, sentry first, no, 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 no. You could have discarded those green cards, you could have trashed that moneylender. Now your turn just stops here.
Tragic.
I mean, the thing is, artisaning for a duchy and then buying a province is probably safe. Because I just don't think Mapo has the gains or like the economy to province duchy here.
Mapo has like some buys and like a couple like one market.
And some gold.
Yeah, one market, a couple of golds, but not like all consistently.
Right, like here they fail to even hit province.
Yeah,
so this should be
now
a win for Prolog here. Now it's in hands.
Yep,
that workshop never got played.
Stunks. Play the workshop for a gardens. Aw, man.
I mean, if anything, I would have artisan for a duchy just to flex a little bit.
Alright, so that's the match. Right.
So was that Prolog wins?
Prolog 4-2, yeah.
4-2, yeah. All right, well, this was fun.
That's nice base games. Thanks, Cooler.
I'm not sure I want to commentate base games in the future just because they're so repetitive. But I hope that the players learned some stuff. And again, we were definitely being very critical, but that's hopefully things that you guys can learn from. We are not actually mean people. We're very nice in the Dominion Discord. We'll always help people at any level, pretty much. But yeah, when we commentate, we're like, no, don't do this thing, because like it just feels wrong to us, and that's how we give you feedback.
Sentry before lab, everyone.
Sentry first. Like, just buy Sentry as soon as you can. It's a good card. They're good cards, Munster.
All right.
All right.
That's all.
See ya.